Hello students, greetings to all. Yes, we were discussed the topic called as a dispersion of light in the human eye and colorful world, right? So of course we have seen what exact meaning of the dispersion of light, and also we have seen when the white light which passes through the prism which splits into its constituent colors, right? So those are called as a vibgayer, right? This is also called as a spectrum or visible spectrum. Right, so these things we have studied, isn't it? So here of course we have studied also, so most deviated ray or most deviated color and least deviated color, and also the most wavelengths and least wavelength. So which color of light which has the most wavelength and the least wavelength, right? So these are all things we have studied in our live classes, right? So next we were also studied that the recombination of the spectrum of white light produced by white light, right? This experiment was done by the Newton, right? So he chooses the two prisms. One is kept lateral and another one is laterally inverted, right? So whenever the white light passes through the one prism, that splits into seven colors, that is red and violet. In between red and violet, we have the other colors of five colors, right? And again, these colors of light, when again they pass through into the another inverted prism, which is placed beside of the one more prism. So then the output ray will be white light, right? So this is because the all the seven colors, they are combined and which forms as a white light. Right, so these are all things we were studied in the live session, right? And also we have studied the rainbow formation, right? So how actually the rainbows will forms, right? So rainbow is a natural phenomenon, so that can be occurred in the sky, isn't it, or in the atmosphere. So this is how it look like. So when the light ray when it comes to the or when it is passes into the raindrop, then again dispersion phenomenon will take place, right? We have discussed this one we have already discussed, isn't it? So the processes, the first thing is that a refraction phenomenon, then afterwards dispersion phenomenon, then later internal reflection, again after that refraction phenomenon, right? So these are all we were discussed in the live classes. This is how actually rainbow formation will take place, right? So this is how actually it looks like, right? And now the new concept, let us introduce, that is called as a atmospheric refraction. So we are already familiar for the word refraction, right? So refraction is nothing but whenever the light ray which passes from one medium to another medium, right? If the light ray passes from one medium to another medium, the light ray changes or deviates its path, right? That is called as a refraction of light. So now here, so this is one medium and here is one medium, right? So now the light ray which is traveling from one medium, or I can call it as a rarer medium, and it passes through the denser medium, that changes its path. Instead of it is moving in a straight line, that deviated towards the normal line, right? This is what a refraction, nothing but. When it comes to the atmospheric refraction, I can say that a refraction of light by Earth's atmosphere, right? Now the refraction will be taken place in the Earth's atmosphere. So that is called as a atmospheric refraction. So there are such phenomena we have all seen in our daily life, right? We have all experienced so much of examples. So one by one we can see here. So first one, I can say that is apparent position of stars. So what do you mean by apparent position? Apparent position is nothing but that is not actually the real position. Suppose I can give you an example. Suppose we can take a beaker, right? That beaker contains a full of water, and we have immersed a coin bottom, or we have kept the coin at the bottom. So this beaker, which is full of water, right? If I see the coin from the outside, right? If I see the coin from the outside, then this coin, we can see that this coin is slightly above from the beaker, right? We can feel that this coin has been raised for some height from its bottom, isn't it? In swimming pools, or when if I take the glass and that is filled with water, if I place the lemon, isn't it? If I place anything in that tumbler, that's look like a bigger in size, isn't it?